Hey, Christy. Miss you. Crazy stuff, huh? Makes us have a lot of appreciation for being able to be in that studio. It's almost 9 o'clock. We'll get started in just a moment. Well, actually, it is 9 o'clock. We'll give it a few more seconds here. Hey, Reba. Morning. It's good to see everybody. This is going to be very gentle. Hey, Judah. Very gentle joint stretching series, which I did not create, but which I learned at a gentle yoga training that I attended about a year ago or so. So you might see me consulting my notes a little bit. It's going to be mostly seated. We will be coming up to all fours. So no real props necessary here today, unless you have a blanket or a pillow that you'd like to sit on. Each blanket makes a nice little pad too, if you need it to sit comfortably or to put under your knees or under your wrists, just for some comfort. And so we are going to get started just seated here today. I have the window open behind me this morning. Instead of closing the curtains, I hope it's okay. It's a beautiful day, and I don't know if you can see them, but there's some really pretty orchids in the window, too. So welcome. Whatever comfortable cross-legged seated position that you would like to get started in today. And then just be there, settle there, and land there in your space, wherever it is. We can't be physically together, but at least we can be virtually together at this moment, right now. So lower the lids, maybe close the eyes, and just start to notice your breath. Feel it coming in and out of your body, through your nose, hopefully. And then we're going to move easefully today. And as we do, realize that you are taking care of yourself. And that is vital, especially at this time in our world. It's so, so important for you to pause. Check in with yourself and take care of yourself. And just the fact that you're sitting here thinking about your breath right now is so, so valuable. And I'd like to start this morning with a three-part breath, but a little different three-part breath than maybe I've taught before. Instead of just three breaths to fill up, see if you can consciously think about three parts filling up. So we'll fill up starting with the lower abdomen, filling up the middle abdomen, filling up into the chest, and then as we breathe out, we'll reverse, empty the chest, empty the belly, empty the lower abs. Let's do a few rounds like that. So inhale, lower belly, inhale, middle, inhale into your chest, and then release the chest, release the belly, release the lower abs. Let's do two more just like that. Into the lower, middle, chest, and then release the chest, the belly, and the lower abs. One more. Inhale, lower, inhale, middle, into the chest, puff up. And then release the chest, release the belly, and release the lower abs. And then from here, I encourage you to maintain an even breath. And by that I mean making the length of the inhalation match the length of the exhalation. Or maybe maybe it's the other way around, right? Maybe you're making the length of the exhalation match the length of the inhalation. But either way, realize that the inhale comes next after the exhale, comes next after the inhale, right? It keeps moving in and out. So maybe a count of four as you inhale, two, three, four, exhale, two, three, four. Now I'm gonna give you a moment to find a number that works for you. Might be four, might be five, might be six. Hey Jenny, we're just getting started with some breathing here, evening out the breath. Before we start to move our joints a little bit to find some gratitude. Right, finding some gratitude for your space, your people. I hope you're finding gratitude for your own health and that of your family and your friends. And I'm grateful that you're here with me this morning to do something good for yourself. So we're going to start by extending the legs out long in this Dandasana, staff pose. So sits bones reaching down and the legs are reaching out. The feet are going to stay active here, so think about the toes reaching back towards your face. And then we're going to inhale. Exhale as you point the toes away from the body. Inhale, point them back towards. Exhale, point. Inhale, up. Exhale, reach them out. Inhale, up. Two more. Extend the toes. Inhale, return. Exhale, extend. Inhale, return. And then just let the legs relax. Getting into the ankle joints here. Next, we're going to move the toes out to the side. So the pinky toes are going to go out to the side and then return to the center. So inhale, just open the feet out like a book kind of. Exhale, return to center. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Open. And close. Two more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Good. Get the legs a little shake here. This next one is kind of a subtle movement. It's not a big, huge movement. So if this is your feet right here, what you're going to do is just turn your feet, the soles of the feet, towards each other. They won't be able to move a whole lot with your legs staying straight here. So take a deep breath in. And then exhale, just curl the ankle joints as you bring the soles towards each other. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, you might feel that in the outer ankles, feels good. Exhale. Inhale. And then exhale. And then just pause there. And then finally for the ankles here, just some circles so the legs, both feet can go in the same circle direction. Make the circles as big and exaggerated as you can, just rotating that ankle joint for three, two, and one. And then wherever you are, just pause and reverse your circles. Making those big ankle circle rolls in the opposite direction. Looks like someone else joined us here this morning. Great. Hey, Connie. Good to see you. For three, two, and one. Let's just pause right there. And we're going to pause with a little forward fold. So if you're not already, make sure you can feel your sits bones reaching down. If you're sitting up on a pad or a blanket or a towel, that's fine too. Or you can sit flat on the floor. Think about your hips rotating forward. We're going to inhale, reach the arms up overhead, and then exhale and just forward fold here. So sometimes the first forward fold of the day can be a little creaky. I definitely feel this in the backs of my legs and the quads. You can always bend your knees slightly here. Pull those heels in a little towards the body so you have a slight bend in the knees still, especially early in the morning and just getting started. And breathe here for 3, 2, 1. Bring the palms to the shins. And just like you would do if you were standing in a forward fold, inhale, push yourself up halfway. Only really, it's all the way, because the spine is nice and long. Palms are still resting on the shins. Crown of the head is reaching high towards the sky. Take a deep breath in. And fold forward. Reach the fingertips out beyond the toes if you can. Reach, 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 reach. And then with an inhale, we're going to lift it all the way up. And then just let the palms come to rest back in your Dandasana. Beautiful. All right, from here, we're going to start with the left leg. Take the hands to the shin or the calf. And just very gently, we're going to lift that leg up with an inhale. With an exhale, we're going to grasp the outside of the calf and bring the knee in towards the body. Inhale, extend it up. Exhale. Reach it in, getting into the knee and into the hip here. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Two more. Breathe in, breathe out. Inhale and exhale. And then just extend that leg out long. Just pause here for a moment. Check and see if you notice any difference one side to the other. Just see how that sits. And then we'll take it to the other side. So just gently holding on to the calf or the shin as you lift the leg up. Right, just gently here. Inhale. And then exhale, squeezing the knee in. Inhale, extend. Exhale, bring it in. Inhale, extend. Exhale, squeeze. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. I lost count. I think that's good. Extend that leg out long. And then just check in and see how that feels. Check in with the breath. How's the even breath going? Good. And then from here, we're going to swing it around to cat-cow. So we're going to come to all fours. And then we're going to get into the spine a little bit, the hips a little bit here. So from here, let's start by inhaling and lowering the belly and lifting the head for cow. And then as you exhale, curl the spine, lower the chin for cat. So take a few rounds here, inhaling for cow and exhaling for cat as you start to move the spine and connect with your breath. Inhale, exhale. Let's do one more here. Inhale, exhale. And then we're going to bring the hips back and come to a child's pose. So your knees can stay in line with your hips here, or you know you can open your knees out towards the side of the mat, which creates this nice open space here for your body to nestle down in. If your chin or your forehead doesn't rest comfortably on the floor here, this is a good time for your little blanket or your pillow that you could bring down and put underneath your forehead. So just pausing right here in your child's pose for a few breaths. Noticing that you can breathe into the back body with that even breathing. And then with your next inhale, start to roll back up to your all fours shape. If you opened your knees out wide, bring them in so you're nice and aligned here with the knees under the hips and the wrists under the shoulders. So we're going to do a little roll here between child's pose and cat-cow pose. So start to arch the back up and lower the chin down. And then as you do, you're going to push the heels back to your child's pose. With your next in-breath, you're going to start to roll back up to all fours, but as you do, lower your belly and lift your head and come into your cow. Then we arch into cat and lower back to child's pose. Let's do a few rounds here. Inhaling as you rise up, roll into cow. Exhaling as you curl and lower back down into child's. Two more like that. Inhale, rise up, cow. Exhale, arch and lower back to child. Inhale, rise up, lower the belly, lift the head. Exhale, arch the back, lower the chin, lower the hips, right back to child's pose. Pause here. Make your way back to your all fours position. It's a little bit of movement for the hip joints here. So start by curling into the left toes, extending the left heel away from the body. Feel a stretch in the back of that calf, and then when you're ready, lift the left leg just up as high as your hip. Feel the left heel reaching away from the body. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, bring your nose to your knee, arch. Inhale, extend. Exhale, nose to knee. Inhale, extend. Nose to knee. Inhale. Nose to knee. Inhale. Last one, bring the nose to the knee. Touch, touch, touch. One more, extend, extend, extend. Lower the left knee. Just pause right there. You can come back to a child's pose for a breath if you like. Someone else is joining. Oh, no. Hey, Connie. No, we got everybody. Good. Thought there was a new person. All right. If you're in your child's pose, roll back up to your all fours. And we'll get this leg on the other side. So curl. Start by curling into the right toes. Pushing the right heel away from the body. Feel that stretch in the back of the right calf. And then when you're ready, just lift the right leg. Feel the right heel reaching away from the body here. And then here we go. We're going to inhale as we curl, bring the nose to the knee. Exhale, extend the right heel away. Inhale, nose to knee. Exhale, extend. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Really reach it out. Lower that knee and then sit back in your child's pose. You're welcome to open your knees out wide if you like. Resting here in your child's pose. Think about walking the fingertips away from the body, maybe even just coming up onto the tips of the fingers. This changes the stretch in the shoulders just a little bit. You can also bring your arms around alongside your body so your fingers and toes are all in line with each other. And again, that just changes the stretch into the shoulders a little bit. All right, then when you're ready, inhale, roll yourself right back up to all fours. One more little hip stretch here. So usually when we come to child's pose, we bring the hips straight back towards the heels. This time, we're going to just take them over to the side, so the hips are just going to come over towards the left, just as far as it is comfortable. And then you're just going to come right through center with an inhale. Exhale the hips over towards the right. So it's not a big movement. Inhale through center, left. Inhale through center, right. Inhale, lean the hips left. Inhale, right. And then one more each side, coming in through center. Exhaling, left. In through center, exhaling, right. And then come right back into center. One more brief visit in child's pose here. Taking in a breath, breathing into the back lungs here. Big breaths in. And then when you're ready, we're going to roll up to come sit with the hips back on the heels. Now this is not a favorite of everyone's, and I get that. So if you'd rather just come to a whatever other comfortable seated position, you may. You're welcome to, of course. Sometimes a padding over the backs of the calves will make this a little bit more accessible. Or if you had something that you could prop up for yourself to sit on this way, that's definitely an option as well. So you decide your seated shape for these next stretches. We're going to get into the wrists and the arms and the shoulders a little bit here. All right, so let's start by extending the arms out long. And of course, if you're sitting like this for too long and your legs start to feel some kind of way, just go ahead and move yourself out, change your position. So take a big breath in. As you exhale, just bend the wrists and lower, point the fingers straight down to the floor. Repeat, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now your fingers can keep going straight out, or if you want to add a little, you could rotate the fingertips up to the sky with your inhale, all the way down to the floor with that exhale. Inhale, reach them up, exhale, lower. Inhale and exhale. Good, just let the arms come to rest right beside the body. And then extend them out again. Turn the palms to face each other. We're just gonna go in and out like this. So we're just kind of going sideways with the wrists, so the fingers turn towards each other and then they turn away, right? So just a little different rotation with the wrist joint there. So let's connect it with our breath, right? We'll inhale as we open out, exhale as we close it back to center. Two more, inhale, and exhale. Good, now just make comfortable soft fists and we'll do some circles. So you can do those circles however you want. Do them in the same direction. You have one wrist going one way, the other wrist going the other. For three, two, change it up, go the other way. For three, two, one, and then just bring the palms to rest on your lap or down by your side. We have someone new here. Hey, friend. Good. All right. Now, we're going to just let those arms rest for a second. And then we're going to extend the palms out with the palms facing up this time. Inhale. You're going to sort of curl the fists in and let the knuckles come to the shoulders. Exhale, extend. Inhale, curl them in. Exhale, extend. All right, so we're getting into the elbows here, the shoulders. Inhale and exhale. Two more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more time, bring those knuckles to the shoulders. This time we're going to take the elbows out to the side, so it's an inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Two more, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. And then just lower the arms and let them relax. Remember, if your legs are starting to scream at you, change your position. You can sit on a block if you have it, on a blanket, on a pillow. Cross-legged, legs could be out straight. You could be sitting in a chair to do this part that we're doing right here. All right, we're going to bring the arms up to 90 degrees, cactus arms. And we're going to take a deep breath in with an exhale, just bending from the shoulders and the elbows, flop down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, lower. Ooh, I feel this in one arm way more than the other. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, lower. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Good. This time we're going to reach the arms up overhead. With an inhale, reach, reach, reach. With an exhale, we're going to swing the arms behind. Now, I kind of have to bend mine to get them to go all the way back. You might have to do that too. So we're going to inhale, reach them up. Exhale, extend them backwards. Inhale, reach. Exhale, lower. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Just let those arms come down by your side and give them a little shake. And then come to your child's pose. Take a little break in your child's pose here. You need to situate yourself on your mat. You can. If you need to extend your legs out and give them a little shake, shake first before you come to your child's pose, you're more than welcome to do that as well. Come into your child's pose. Rest your hips comfortably onto your heels. Rest your head comfortably onto the mat or onto a pillow. And breathe. And remember to find that gratitude. We have someone else. Hey, Cassie. So good to see everyone. I miss you guys. A few more breaths here in your child's pose. And then when you're ready, slowly roll yourself on up. We're going to swing the legs around and come to sit on your bottom if you're not already there. Bring those legs out in front. Extend them out long. Dandasana, staff pose. Let the toes be active here, reaching back up towards your body. The spine is nice and long. The sitting bones are reaching down. The crown of the head is reaching up. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, fold forward here. See how this forward fold feels compared to maybe the first one that we did earlier. And remember, if you're still feeling tight behind the legs here, you could scooch those heels in just a little bit and keep a slight bend in the knees, even in your seated forward fold, just like you would do or might do in a standing forward fold. Bring the palms to the shins. Press the hands down into the legs as you inhale and come upright. And then exhale and fold forward. This time reach the fingertips out, straight out as far as you can. Breathe in and come all the way up. Exhale, just let the arms come to rest in your lap or alongside your body. We're actually going to cross the legs at this point, so whatever's comfortable cross-legged position you can sit in. And again, if you're up on a block or a towel or a blanket, that's perfectly fine. This is a little seated cat-cow, so slightly different feeling than the other cat-cow moves that we've done. Well, breathe in, and as you do, start to arch the back just slightly, chin lifts, and gaze up. And then as you exhale, curl the back, lower the chin, round the shoulders for cat. Take a few rounds here, connecting with your breath, inhaling as you lift and look up, and exhaling as you roll and curl in. Three more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. And one more. Breathe in. Round and make this one the best rounded one yet. And then just come to sit comfortably with a neutral spine. Take the left hand to the right knee And then take your right hand right behind your lower back here. We're going to get into a little seated twist. So as you do this, you want to think about your spine getting long, so the crown of your head is reaching high towards the sky, and then you're twisting from the waist, right? So as you start to look around behind you, if that's comfortable, looking over the right shoulder, seeing what you can see behind you, with each inhale, think about the body getting taller and longer, and with each exhale, think about it twisting just a tiny bit farther. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, twist. Two more big breaths here. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale. And exhale. And then when you're ready, just ever so slowly, just unwind yourself all the way back through center and just slowly do a slight little unwind over to the opposite side before you return to neutral. And then just pause there for a moment. Let's see how that feels. Good. And then switch the order of your legs, whichever one's on top or in the front. Switch it around. Put that in the opposite way. So this might be the awkward feeling seat. And we're going to take the right hand to the left knee. Left hand is going to come right behind the lower back. And then we're going to breathe. Each time we inhale, we're going to get longer and taller. Each time we exhale, twisting a little farther. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe in. Breathe out. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Slowly, slowly, slowly unwind through center. And just a slight little counter unwind to the other side. And then return to center. Gotta just pause here, check in. So we're going to get into the neck joint just a little bit. We're almost finished. Pretty much gotten all the joints in. Inhale as you start to tip the head backwards. Now this can be tricky if you have any neck issues, so you have to decide what's comfortable for you. Maybe you're only gazing about midway up the wall. Maybe you can start to move the gaze up to where the ceiling and the wall meet. Or maybe if it's comfortable, you can let that head rest all the way back with your nose pointing up towards the sky. It really stretches out into your throat as well. But be where you need to be and breathe there. For three, two, and one. You might even want to take your hand to your head and slowly help it rise up. Good. Pause there with a neutral spine. Take a deep breath in, and then this time we're going to just let the head fall forward. So again, you decide how far forward it goes. But if you can let the weight of the head relax down, you can feel a nice stretch into the back of the neck here. And breathe there for three, two, and one. Inhale as your head comes upright. Just pause there. Good. Take a deep breath in. This time the left ear is just going to lean towards the left shoulder. So nice opening stretch into the right side of the neck here. Letting the ear hang towards the shoulder and just letting the weight of the head stretch the side of the neck here. If you like, and if your neck is healthy, you can sort of turn your head a little bit to look down towards your shoulder, if that feels okay. And then you could turn it more ear towards shoulder. So if that slight little movement feels okay on your neck, it just changes the stretch a little bit, slowly moving back and forth. Ear to shoulder, nose to shoulder. Or just holding here for 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, you might even use your hand to gently guide your head back to center. That sucker is heavy. Pause right there. Big breath in, right ear towards the right shoulder. Breathing here, being grateful here, and then if you like, slowly and gently turning the nose toward the shoulder, ear towards the shoulder, nose towards the shoulder, ear towards the shoulder, or just staying still here for 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, maybe use the hand to gently lift the head back upright. Pause here. I don't know if you can hear them or not, but the birds are singing outside the window. It's beautiful. In lieu of music, we have birds singing. One more little neck stretch here, and all we're going to do is take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, just turn to look over your left shoulder. Just the neck is turning here. Inhale, come through center. Exhale, towards the right shoulder. Inhale through center. Nice and slow and controlled. Exhale, left. Inhale, center. Exhale, right. One more each side. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Inhale, center, and exhale, right. Inhale, back through center, and then just pause. Good. I'm going to have you come swing those legs around and just come on down to your belly. So however you get there, down to your belly. You can stack your palms if you like to make a little padding for your forehead, or you could use your pillow or your blanket, or you could just let your cheek come to rest all the way down on the floor, whatever feels comfortable for your back. And then wherever you are, just bend your knees and let the legs just windshield wiper back and forth here a little bit. And then when you're ready, just let the legs extend, tops of the feet come down to the floor, maybe the toes point in or maybe the toes point out, whatever feels comfortable for you. And then a slight little back bend here is in a Sphinx pose, so we'll just come on up to the elbows. We'll keep the elbows in line under the shoulders, the forearms pointing straight out, fingers are wide. And pressing the palms and the fingertips down into the mat, and then gazing forward. You can even start to look up again towards the middle of the wall, or up towards where the wall meets the ceiling if that feels okay, or maybe not. Maybe your head stays lowered and your gaze down towards the floor. But either way, feeling a slight bend into the lower back here. If your glute muscles are engaged, try to release them and breathe for 3, 2, and 1. And then just lower yourself right back down, either to rest your forehead or your cheek on the floor. One more time, bending the knees and a little windshield wiper with those calves back and forth, feet back and forth. And then when you're ready, just roll right over onto your back. It doesn't really matter which way your head is facing. If you want to get up and flick the other way, whatever's comfortable for you. Just coming to rest flat on your back. Maybe bringing the knees in for a little stretch. little squeeze here, maybe a little rocking back and forth. If you like, you could reach in between your knees and grab a hold of your feet for a happy baby. But as I say, you have to smile when you're doing happy baby. You could do a little rock back and forth. And then once you're ready, find your way to your final relaxation, your shavasana. So your legs might be extended out long on the mat with the arms alongside the body. Some people prefer to keep the knees bent to protect the lower back here. And you might even choose to have your arms in that cactus pose if that feels good on your shoulders. You choose your shavasana shape. And then you can let go of that evened out breathing. Just release, relax, and enjoy as many minutes of peace here after your joint freeing series as you might like to enjoy. And I hope the rest of your day is as peaceful as it can be. And I hope to see you either here on this virtual screen or for real in a yoga studio, in the yoga studio.